As we advance our technology ever forward, you would think that remaking a 50-year-old design should be easy, but things are not quite as simple as they first seem. Curious droid. When the Space Launch System, or the SLS, was in development, NASA ran the Advanced Booster Competition to find a new booster system, and two of the three entries used liquid-fueled engines. Liquid-fueled boosters would be safer and could be shut down in the event of a problem, unlike the solid rocket boosters, which can't. However, unlike the space shuttle, the new boosters would be single-use only and would burn up when they fell back to Earth. But which liquid-fueled engines would be powerful enough? There really aren't any massive engines in use today. The boosters could use the same modified RS-25D engines, those left over from the space shuttle program, which would also be used for the SLS's main core stage. But that would be very wasteful of a complex, expensive, and yet highly efficient engine. Now, we've already had an engine capable of doing the job, the mighty Rocketdyne F-1, the huge engines which took men to the moon with the Apollo program, but they haven't been built since the 1960s. The F-1 engines were not only extremely powerful, but they were also simple, which meant they were cheap enough to be disposable. So why don't we just remake them? Now, there is a common myth which says NASA lost or threw away the blueprints, which of course is complete rubbish. Every design document ever created for the Apollo program is still available. But if it was just a case of wheeling out old designs, they would have done that years ago. No, the problem is not the design, but it's the way in which the world has moved on since the engineers first created those F-1 engines back in the 1960s. When a group of present-day rocket engineers looked at how they could recreate the iconic F-1 engines, they soon realised just how differently things were done some 50 years ago, when there was no computer-aided design, just slide rules and trial and error testing. Components were designed, built, and then tested, and then often modified before being used. Complex engine sub-assemblies were welded together from sometimes hundreds of smaller parts, with skilled welders taking sometimes a day to complete one complex weld. Although they had the original blueprints, what they found that was missing was the notes made by the engineers as they effectively handcrafted every engine, each one slightly different with its own quirks and foibles. The original builders of the F-1 engines were highly skilled engineers, welders and fitters that did almost everything by hand, because often that was the only way to do it back then. And in the rush to meet deadlines, they kept many of the tricks that they used to get things to work and go together in their heads, or scribbled down on scraps of paper long since lost. Roll on 50 years, and all of those skilled people have long since retired and many have passed away, taking their skills and knowledge with them. With the advent of modern manufacturing techniques, many of those skills are no longer in use, and few people today have them. So faced with 50-year-old blueprints, we find we just don't have the people with the skills that can make them in the same way anymore. By detailed examination of the remaining F-1 engines from museums and storage, our new engineers did discover enough to create a new F-1B engine, should it ever be built. Using modern computer modelling and manufacturing techniques, the new engine could not only be more efficient, it would be just as powerful as the uprated but unflown F-1A at 1.8 million pounds of thrust, but more importantly, it would reduce the number of manufactured parts from some 5,600 to just 40, and increase its reliability and decrease costs in the process. Although in the end NASA selected the solid rocket boosters for the SLS, this exercise proved that it's sometimes easier to redesign something from scratch than it is to try and remake the past. So what do you think of remaking the F-1 engines and also this new short video format? Let me know in the comments. And I'd just like to take time to thank all of our patrons for their ongoing support and thank all of you for watching. And please subscribe, rate and share.